own land in hip-hop. To think about the origins of hip-hop in this culture, and also about homeland security, is to see that there are, at the very least, two worlds in America. One of the well-to-do, and another of the struggling. For if ever there was the absence of homeland security, it is seen in the gritty roots of hip-hop. For the music arises from a generation that feels, with some justice, that they have been betrayed by those who came before them. That they are, at best, tolerated in schools, feared on the streets, and almost inevitably destined for the hellholes of prison. They grew up hungry, hated, and unloved. And this is the psychic fuel that generates the anger that seems endemic in much of the music and poetry. One senses very little hope above the personal goals of wealth to climb above the pit of poverty. In the broader society, the opposite is true. For here, more than any other place on earth, wealth is so widespread and so bountiful that what passes for the middle class in America could pass for the upper class in most of the rest of the world. Their very opulence and relative wealth makes them insecure, and homeland security is a governmental phrase that is as oxymoronic, as crazy as, say, military intelligence or the U.S. Department of Justice. They're just words that have very little relationship to reality. Now, do you feel safer now? Do you think you will anytime soon? Do you think duct tape and Kleenex and color codes will make you safer? From Death Row, this is Mumia Abu-Jamal.
There are many governments, business interests, even religious leaders that would like to see me depart this earth. I'll grant them their wish soon enough. But before I do, I wish to make a small contribution, a final gesture of goodwill to the people of this little planet that have given, from whom I have taken so much.
Freedom of speech, motherfucker.
I got no strings holding okay. Me down to make me fret.
Something for the kids. Step in the club smoothly, with the L in my hand. Bitches know that I'm a freak, like the Elephant Man. Intelligent plans, fuck a record deal. I want development land with my benevolent clan. And that's the reason that I only trust my fam. 40,000 records sold, 400 grand. Fuck a middleman, I won't pay anyone else. I'll bootleg it and sell it to the streets myself. I'd rather be that than signed and stuck on a shelf. And because of this, executives try to diss me.
Yeah.
Racism frozen in time like Walt Disney. And now they say they wanna get me signed to the major. If I switch up my politics and change my behavior, tryna tell me what the rhyme about over the beat. Bitch niggas that never spent a day in the street. But I repeat that, nobody can hold my reins. I put the truth on tracks, nigga, simple and plain.
I got no strings, so I have fun. I'm not tied up to anyone. They got strings, but you can see there are no strings on me.
I guess to America, I'm a disaster.
Oh, no.
A slave that was destined to own his masters. Independent in every single sense of the word. I say what I want, you fucking little sensitive herb. This is America, I thought we had freedom of speech. But now you wanna try to control the way that I speak. And O'Reilly, you think you a patriot?
Yeah, right.
You ain't nothing but a motherfucking racist bitch. Full of hatred, pressing a button, trying to eject me. But I don't got no motherfucking deal with Pepsi. No corporate sponsor telling me what to do. Asking me to tone it down during an interview. Trying to minimize the issue, but I'm keeping it large. I love the place I live, but I hate the people in charge. Speaking is hard when you got strings attached, so I'ma say it for you, cause I don't got none of that. And if you didn't understand what I spit at your brain, ayo son, let this little nigga explain.
I got no strings, so I have fun. I'm not tied up to anyone. They got strings, but you can see there are no strings on me.
Come on, son, y'all niggas know the way that I do. ImmortalTechnique.com live for you. And I know sometimes it be making you nervous the way I smash puppet rappers that belong in a circus. You motherfuckers just can't compare. Looking for a fan base that's no longer there. I know that you're scared and you're hiding up in the cut, but this is freedom of speech, nigga, tell them what's up. Word, nigga, fuck John Ashcroft. Nigga, fuck Fox News. Fuck those snake-ass bitches trying to manipulate your opinion, telling you what to think. Word the fuck up, nigga. Like, we invading niggas cause we wanna free them. You racist motherfucker. You don't give a shit about those people. You can suck my dick.
Relax, Tech, relax.
Another rum and coke at the bar, nigga. It's my day off.
Word up.
Fuck. For the kids. Ah! For the kids. Beat bandits.
Man, you hear this bullshit they be talking? Every day, man, it's like these motherfuckers is just like professional liars, you know what I'm saying? Wow. Listen, Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga. Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga. Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga. Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Pledge no allegiance, nigga, fuck the president's speeches. I'm baptized by America and covered in leeches. The dirty water that bleaches your soul and your facial features. Drowning you in propaganda that they spit through the speakers. And if you speak about the evil that the government does, the Patriot Act attract you to the type of your blood. They try to frame you and say you was trying to sell drugs and throw a federal indictment on niggas to show you love. This shit is run by fake Christians, fake politicians. Look at their mansions and look at the conditions you live in. All they talk about is terrorism on television. They tell you to listen, but they don't really tell you their mission. They funded Al-Qaeda, and now they blame the Muslim religion. Even though Bin Laden was a CIA tactician, they gave him billions of dollars, and they funded his purpose. Fahrenheit 9/11, that's just scratching the surface.
Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga. Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga. Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga. Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Say the rebels in Iraq still fight for Saddam, but that's bullshit. I show you why it's totally wrong. Cause if another country invaded the hood tonight, it'd be warfare through Harlem and Washington Heights. I wouldn't be fighting for Bush or white America's dream. I'd be fighting for my people's survival and self-esteem. I wouldn't fight for racist churches from the south, my nigga. I'd be fighting to keep the occupation out, my nigga. You ever clock someone who talks shit or look at you wrong? Imagine if they shot at you and was raping your moms. And of course Saddam Hussein had chemical weapons. We sold them that shit after Ronald Reagan's election. Mercenary contractors fighting a new era. Corporate military banking off the war on terror. They controlling the ghetto with the fear of attack, trying to distract the fact that they engineering the crack. So I'm strapped like Lee Malvo holding a sniper rifle. These bullets will touch your kids, and I don't mean like Michael. Your body be sent to the morgue, stripped down and recycled. I fire on house niggas that support you and like you, cause innocent people get murdered in the struggle daily, and poor people never get shit and struggle daily. This ain't no alien conspiracy theory. This shit is real. Written on a dollar underneath the Masonic seal.
Y'all don't rap for dead presidents. I'd rather see the president dead. It's never been said, but I set precedents.
Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga. Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga.
Bush knocked down the towers.
Tell the truth, nigga. Bin Laden didn't blow up the projects. It was your nigga.
City records was 80 seconds away from the tower. Some cowards fought with the wrong building. They meant to hit